because this is a homage beat.
Okay, so what you're going to find on the Cossack to Sip is a lot of that hip rotation, being able to control the lower part of the spine in your abs. So what you're going to need is a lot of internal rotation, but also external rotation, which is one of the reasons why it's a good one to use if you want squats, or if you just want to develop better hip mobility and just some functionality for your hips. So one of the first exercises I work on is the shin box position, just here. Make sure your knee is level with your hip, so that if you were to turn this way, everything is in line. And all you're going to try and do is swim into this position here. Trick is though, you're trying to pull your knees up into your armpits. This is going to be important to learn for the Cossack Sip. So swivel over, drive your knees into the floor, try and keep your chest this way. Drive up, pull the armpits into the knees into the armpits. So you're going to feel a lot of activation through here. You may even feel a little bit through the lats. And then swivel. Okay, this is the first movement you need to work on, so you can build some rotation and active ability to compress and internally rotate the hip without impinging it. Side to side, again, it's a movement you might have to do quite slowly before you can start to add a little bit of speed, a little bit of pop to it. So you're going to go into your Cossack squat position, hands going to go behind, you're going to slowly lower yourself to the floor by internally rotating. You need to make sure you keep the foot in the same position you did your Cossack squat. Now, we're going to practice is staying here, we're trying to pull the knee up into the armpit, okay, as you go through. So again, you're trying to keep yourself sitting this way, so as you bring the knee up, you're not sitting back, you're bringing the knee up into the armpit. So staying in the same position, so you're not doing this, you're actually bringing the knee up to here, okay? Here. Here. You need to get a mat as well. Just to elevate, you're going to put this behind you, like this. And all you're going to practice doing is going from here, and I want you to externally rotate this leg, so turn the toes back, and try and get it around, and you're slowly going to internally rotate this leg. And the aim of this one is, as you go down, I want you to imagine you're trying to keep your armpit pasted to your knee. So as I go down, I'm trying to keep my armpit over my knee. So then as I come back up, I'm not having to jog forwards, because my weight is already sitting forwards like this. Okay, then all you do to progress this is you slowly take a mat away. Again, these toes are turning backwards to externally rotate while this knee is turning inwards. And again, as we come through, you need to make sure your armpit is staying as close to the leg as you can. So it helps, one thing that can help to guide you is take this elbow, slide it down the shin like this. And pop back up. And eventually what should happen is, just from learning that control, you'll do eccentrics where you slide down into the floor and come back up. And if you need to for this, to build that last little bit of strength, go here, slide down as slowly as you can, then you use the two fingertips like this on the floor to pop yourself up. You may find that one side's gonna come easier than the other, but after doing those drills, you should get it pretty quickly. For some of you who are very mobile, who can already achieve a deep squat and a normal Cossack squat, this could get you this movement in about, well, probably like 20 minutes if you try it. Give that a try and let me know how you get on.